Hey guys, welcome back to Top Talk TV, where everything comes off the top. In today's review, we're going to be watching from toptrending.com 10 most dangerous places in the world. You guys ready?
Let's do it.
All right.
It's a 40-mile stretch of cotton fields and ghost towns. It runs along the Rio Grande and is just a few steps away from the 18-foot fence of the U.S. border. Dubbed the Murder Valley, it holds the title of the world's most dangerous place. The town, which used to have 60,000 members of its community, now has around 5,000 surviving residents, which live in fear. Run by the cartels, the streets are known for being regularly decorated with drugs, blood, and corpses. Juarez Valley averages 160 murders per 100,000 residents. Annually, the murder rate is incredibly high, not only due to the normality of crime, but also due to the fact that cartels are fighting over each other for control of the territory. The majority of the shops have been closed for good, with gravestones lining the streets in remembrance of those who have been killed. The buildings are full of gang graffiti, a lot of them markers of how many have been murdered on the marked spots, serving as warnings to others. The entire town looks like a scene from a horror movie, poverty-stricken. Full of ruins, with the townspeople too afraid to leave their own homes. Whoever does dare to walk outside is more than likely to end up being killed, tortured, or kidnapped. The police officers who were sent to intervene had been executed in 2009, and for fear of the wretchedness of the place, they have never been replaced. One of the few routes which connect the Amazon rainforest with the capital of that area of Bolivia is a road with a quite discouraging name. Known as the Death Road. The road was built by Paraguayan prisoners in the 1930s, and it underwent modernization about 20 years ago, beginning at 15,400 feet and taking the lives of approximately 300 people a year. It's quite surprising to find out that the Death Road is one of Bolivia's greatest tourist attractions. Adrenaline seekers seem to be drawn to the deadly route. Considered the world's most dangerous stretch of road, the 40-mile journey offers stunning views of the rolling hills of the Amazon rainforest, but is quite a feat for a mountain biker to undertake. It comes with a terrifying sheer drop into the canopy, as two rubber tires separate the rider from a narrow single-lane road. With very little in the way of railings, the thrilling downhill ride has taken 18 mountain biking enthusiasts' lives in the last 10 years. The North Anatolian Fault is an active fault, and quite a threatening one. Since the 1930s, devastating earthquakes have been moving westward throughout the land. The last big earthquake struck in 1999, with a 7.9 magnitude tremor devastating the city of Izmit. The death toll was a staggering number of 45,000. The fact that the wave of earthquakes is creeping westward is very worrying, because the fault stretches 20 kilometers south of Istanbul, the largest city in Turkey. Istanbul is the country's economical, cultural, and historical heart. With a population of 14.4 million people, Istanbul is not only significant for Turkey, but for the world, as it is the world's fifth largest city, and the fault makes it one of the most dangerous places to live. Scientists expect that the next earthquake will shake the ground dangerously close to the city, with the possibility of triggering a series of small to moderate quakes. However, studies show that it's also possible the fault will create just one big, devastating shift in the ground, which could be the end of Istanbul and the death of millions. One of Africa's great lakes, Lake Kivu, is located along the border between the Democratic Republic of Congo and Rwanda, stretching across 2,700 square miles. The lake covers dangerous secrets. Below it, there are 2.3 trillion cubic feet of methane gas, alongside 60 cubic miles of carbon dioxide trapped beneath the lake under the pressure of the water and the earth. If the gases were to be released from their trap, they would spread a lethal cloud over the whole area, meaning certain death for over 2 million Africans settled in the basin of Lake Kivu. In the 1980s, two similar African lakes released their toxic gases and resulted in the deaths of over 1,000 people. Scientists are concerned that the same fate awaits the residents of the Lake Kivu area, as it has similar chemical composition. The deadly toxins are caused by volcanic activities taking place hidden away underneath the massive lake. San Pedro Sula is a city in Honduras, located not far from the Caribbean Sea. With an estimated population of 1 million, it is the second largest city in Honduras. However, the city sadly has a negative reputation. In 2013, it has taken the title of the most dangerous city on the planet, stripping Mexico's Murder Valley of the title. That same year, upon claiming the title of the most violent place on the planet, the city had seen 187 homicides per 100,000 residents. The city is a major operational and strategic point for distribution of drugs and arms. With significant gang activity, it is the center of trafficking, providing the rest of the country with its 70% of illegal firearms, which in turn result in the 83% of the homicides. Labeled the murder capital of the world, San Pedro Sula is a place where tomorrow is always an uncertainty. If you venture about 90 miles off the coast of Sao Paulo, Brazil, you will likely come across a small chunk of uninhabited land called Ilha de Queimada Grande. This island is, in fact, one of the deadliest islands in the world, also known as Snake Island. It is home to one of the most dangerous and poisonous snakes on the planet, the Golden Lancehead Viper. Local legends say that there are as much as 5 snakes per square meter, but in reality, there are about 2,000 of them on this 430,000 square meter island. Still, walking through it is more dangerous than a minefield. It is said that the stark and potent venom of the viper slowly paralyzes and liquefies the insides of the prey. But it has yet to be proven, as no one bitten has ever lived long enough to be admitted to a hospital. The sole inhabitant of this island was a lighthouse keeper who ran out of food and disappeared while trying to gather some bananas. According to legend, the members of his search party mysteriously vanished one by one, lost in the wilderness. Civilians are banned from the island, monitored by the Brazilian Navy, and the rules are bent very rarely for the sake of scientific research. Situated in the Huyan city, Mount Hua is known for its beautiful views and vistas, but also dangerous and deadly paths. Considered a holy place, Mount Hua is one of China's great 5 mountains. Monks and pilgrims made paths and staircases as ways to climb the mountains in order to reach the 5 peaks. However, the climb is not for the faint-hearted. The mountain is considered the most dangerous climb in the world. With time, the paths have been reinforced because of the incline in tourists venturing out and seeking adrenaline-inducing adventures. But this mountain still remains one of the most difficult sites to conquer on Earth. The plank trail consists of wooden platforms, a bit over 2 feet wide, bolted onto the mountainside, and the only thing to secure oneself to it is an iron chain, which hovers freely in the air. And when the planks disappear, the only way to continue is by crossing steps on small divots carved into the mountain. Unfortunately, there are no exact statistics as to how many people die while on this path. But with local rumors naming about 100 deaths per year, the hike on Huashan surely lives up to its name, the deadliest hike in the world. The Danakil Depression lies at the heart of Ethiopia's ancient salt trade, where Ethiopians have been making the long 2-day trek to collect the salt for centuries, collecting it from the golden earth and bringing them back on camels. One of the hottest and harshest environments in the world, the sun and salt create amazing sun-blazed scenery, making the desert seem as if it were created out of white gold. The swirling sulfur and mineral salt formations create otherworldly scenery, creating an outlandish setting. One of the lowest places on the planet, the Danakil Desert rarely sees rain, and is one of the hottest spots on Earth, where rivers dry up and turn into lakes of salt. With magma crater lakes on its edges, products of active volcanoes, the desert proves to be an extreme challenge to human beings trying to cross it. The Maya Mariupol Complex was an area in Russia which served as secret headquarters for nuclear research and development. Most of the workers in the underground facilities were prisoners who agreed to work in such conditions in exchange for a lesser sentence. They were accompanied by leading Soviet nuclear scientists. Still, none of them survived to see freedom, as no one could survive such high-level radiation for more than 5 years. Wow. The Mayak experiment was the source of many nuclear disasters. The research proved lethal for the residents of the 24 villages along the banks of the river, as the radioactive waste had been dumped into the river, which was the source of drinking water for the villagers for 6 entire years. In 1957, a radioactive waste containment sector failed and exploded, the toxins affecting over 250,000 people in the area. The people were evacuated only 10 days later, after being already exposed. By 1959, every tree within a 12-mile radius was dead. All of this was covered up by the government, leaving the people clueless to the lethal dangers they were living beside. Based on the number of violent crimes per 1,000 residents, and taking into account how many of those have needed the involvement of the FBI, Camden has taken the title of the most dangerous city in the USA. Camden is situated in the state of New Jersey, on the east coast of the Delaware River. In the past year, Camden has seen 1,895 violent crimes, taking into account murder, rape, robbery, and aggravated assault. This might not sound like a great amount of crimes when compared to some other big cities. For example, Camden's neighbor across the river, Philadelphia, has seen 17,088 violent crimes last year. However, the key element that needs to be taken into consideration is the population of the city, which consequently leads to the average number of violent crimes per 1,000. Which in Camden soars over the national average of 3.8 violent crimes per 1,000 people, with 25.66, more than 6 times the national average. This all leads to the conclusion that the chances of you becoming a victim of a violent crime is 1 in 39.
Man, Camden is like almost like a giant homeless shelter. In a way, because you see there weren't much businesses around, so what people going to do to for jobs or anything like that? You see any prey on the street, you get them, so you can have something to eat for tonight.
That is so sad. That place, Camden in Mexico, what was that place, San Juan?
Juarez.
Like, all that real estate gone to waste. All that real estate.
I knew you were thinking about that. I knew you were thinking about that.
And those drug cartels, they wanna run their business, the guns and drugs, because United States people take so many drugs, people down there wanna make a profit off of it.
Yeah, but it's like hurt all these other people.
Yeah.
That could, like, it's just the way drug dealers do things. Right. Yeah. Like, I understand it. The way they move, but I don't understand why you have to continuously hurt people. Yes, to make a statement, if you're fighting other cartels and stuff like that, fine, but all these innocent people, you can.
Just trying to scare people into compliance.
Right, at least be the drug dealers that replenish their community.
Right.
And another one that got to me was the Istanbul in Turkey, because they have that fault that's right there, and all those people living in that small little area, like, it's like something like 9 million people in New York City, or something like 14 million in Istanbul.
Yeah.
And if they have, and that earthquakes keep moving closer and closer to that city, so sooner or later, a lot of people are going to die.
Yeah.
And also when he talked about that island off the coast of Sao Paulo in Brazil with all those snakes, it's like, dude, you can't even go there. The government won't even let you there unless you're some kind of researcher or something like that. So that place has got to be super scary, too.
And a lot of these places, though, are really beautiful.
Yeah.
Oh, really, really gorgeous. Yeah. Yes.
It isn't makes you not want to do anything.
And isn't it true how Mother Nature works, though?
Yeah.
The most beautiful things is, like, is you know, the most dangerous area.
Like the fish or frogs with all the colors on it. Yeah. That's a display to the other animals. If you eat me, you're just going to get poisoned. You know, animals that have the bright green or bright red.
Yeah.
If you eat me, if you try to eat me, it's on.
Yeah.
Got something for that ass?
I wouldn't mind a pair of snake boots that color. No, I'm teasing. I'm teasing.
Your feet start swelling up. Your feet start swelling up because of this skin.
And you know, I don't get adrenaline junkies. Like, I mean.
Crossing that Chinese road.
Yes. And it's like, it just looks like a
death. Yeah.
It's like, you look, really? Wood and a chain?
Yeah.
And or that road. One, right.
That really, road. Yeah. I was like, oh no, you ain't getting me on there.
Right. Girl, I don't have the upper body strength to hold myself up.
Right.
And those stairs going to the temple.
It was like straight up.
And it's like, you just don't do it. You just don't do it. It's like, is it really that much of a rush
you need to
like,
give me a helicopter or a hang glider or something.
Right. Or like those mountain climbers that sleep on the side of the mountains just hanging in the air. Mm-hmm. Like, are you serious?
Yeah.
And they just have like the four chains and they hook it up to a little
cracks. Yeah.
And then it's like a sleeping bag. How you not gonna roll off?
Yep.
I like to roll, sleep
don't,
sideways.
Don't walk in your sleep.
Or what happens when Mother Nature decides to wake up?
Yeah.
And a piece of that rock just gets stuck into that crack, and you just aggravated the earth.
Like, it's not worth my life.
Or wind.
Right.
Like, indoor rock climbing for me.
But this is good. This is a really good video. Now we know where not to go.
In the world. Yeah, we know where not to go. Thank you guys for coming out for Top Talk TV. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and
follow our social medias.
And
hit that notification button.
And we will see you next time on Top Talk TV.
Peace.
Peace.